आई एम डॉक्टर राजेश्वरी, वर्किंग एज एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ डेमोग्राफी एट इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर हैदराबाद। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विथ यू अबाउट नेशनल हेल्थ एंड फैमिली सर्वे। इन दिस मॉड्यूल वी डिस्कस मेनली अबाउट नेशनल फैमिली हेल्थ सर्वे इन डिटेल, फोकसिंग द अटेंशन ऑन द फॉलोइंग इश्यूज। नीड फॉर नेशनल फैमिली एंड हेल्थ सर्वे, डिफरेंट राउंड्स ऑफ NFHS, National Family Health Survey findings, comparisons of NFHS. What is the need for a National Family Health Survey? India has been trying to tackle the problem of population through improved use of family planning methods since before the emergency rattled the political system. Family planning and contraception methods attack the very root of beliefs, several major sections of the Indian society, and hence the issue of population control continues to challenge the nation's policy makers and implementers. But until 1992-93, the national census was the only source of statistics which reported only the growing numbers and not the factors involved. Detailed statistics regarding utilization of family planning measures, reasons for non-use of available methods, types of methods preferred, etc., were all unaccounted for. Today, the policy makers can say whether it is a popular belief, lack of access, lack of awareness, or familial disapproval that keep both men and women from implementing family planning measures. All of this is being made possible through extensive sample surveys conducted by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, called the National Family Health Survey, NFHS. NFHS was started by Government of India in 1992-93 as the first large-scale multi-round household survey conducted at a national level. It was done in a representative sample of households throughout India and has been conducted four times since then. The National Family Health Survey is a large-scale multi-round survey. It is conducted in a representative sample of households throughout India. Therefore, it is a household sample survey carried out in 24 states and Delhi for NFHS-1. The NFHS is a collaborative project of the International Institute for Population Sciences, IIPS, Mumbai, ORC Macro, Calverton, Maryland, USA, and East-West Center, Honolulu, Hawaii, USA. NFHS gives accurate national and state-level estimates. This was conducted under the stewardship of Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. IIPS was the nodal agency responsible for providing coordination and technical guidance for the NFHS. NFHS was funded by the United States Agency for International Development, USAID, with supplementary support from United Nations Children's Fund, UNICEF. Four rounds of the survey have been conducted since the first survey in 1992-93. NFHS-1 was conducted in 92-93, NFHS-2 in 1998 and 99, NFHS-3 in 2005 and 2006, NFHS-4 in 2015 and 16. The first National Family Health Survey, NFHS-1, was an important component of the project to strengthen the survey research capabilities of the Population Research Centers, PRCs, in India, launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, New Delhi, in 1991. The main objective of the survey was to collect reliable and up-to-date information on fertility, family planning, mortality, and maternal and child health. Data collection was carried out in three phases from April 1992 to September 1993. NFHS-1 was a major landmark in the development in the demographic database for India. The second National Family Health Survey, NFHS-2, was conducted in 1998-99. The NFHS-2 is the outcome of collaborative efforts of many organizations. The International Institute for Population Sciences, IIPS, was designated as the nodal agency for this project by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, New Delhi. The project was funded by the United States Agency for International Development, USAID, with additional support from UNICEF. Technical guidance was provided by Macro International and East-West Center, USA. Responsibility for data collection was entrusted to 13 reputed organizations in India, including some population research centers. The objective is to provide state and national estimates of fertility, the practice of family planning, infant and child mortality, maternal and child health, and the utilization of health services provided to mothers and children. In addition, the survey includes information on the quality of health and family welfare services and provides indicators of the status of women, women's reproductive health, and domestic violence. Another feature of NFHS2 is measurement of the nutritional status of women. The survey covers a representative sample of about 91,000 ever married women aged 15 to 49 from 26 states in India who were covered in two phases, the first starting in November 1998 and the second in March 1999. The survey provides state-level estimates of demographic and health parameters as well as data on various socio-economic and programmatic dimensions which are critical for bringing about the desired change in demographic and health parameters. One important feature of NFHS2 is the data on nutritional status of women and children collected by carrying out blood tests for hemoglobin levels in addition to the measurement of their height and weight. In 2005 and 6, National Family Health Survey, NFHS3, is the third in series of national surveys. The International Institute for Population Sciences, Mumbai, served as the nodal agency. ORC Macro, Calverton, Maryland, USA, provided the technical assistance for all three NFHS surveys. NFHS1 and NFHS2 were funded by the United States Agency for International Development with supplemental funding from UNICEF. The NFHS3 funding was provided by the United States Agency for International Development, the Department for International Development, United Kingdom, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, UNICEF, the United Nations Population Fund, and Government of India. In NFHS3, 18 research organizations conducted interviews with more than 2,30,000 women aged 15 to 49 and men aged 15 to 54 throughout India. NFHS3 also tested more than 1 lakh women and men for HIV and more than 2 lakh adults and young children for anemia. Fieldwork for NFHS3 was conducted from December 2005 to August 2006. Assistance for the HIV component was provided by the National AIDS Control Organization and the National AIDS Research Institute. The NFHS4, the National Family Health Survey in 2015-16, NFHS4 is the fourth in the NFHS series, provides information on population, health and nutrition for India and each state union territory. NFHS4 for the first time provides district level estimates for many important indicators. NFHS4 is the first of the NFHS series that collects data in each of India's 29 states and all 7 union territories. Also, NFHS4 for the first time will provide estimates of most indicators at district level for all 640 districts of the country included in the 2011 census. The contents of previous rounds of NFHS are generally retained and additional components are added from one round to another. In this round, information on malaria prevention, migration in the context of HIV, abortion, violence during pregnancy, etc. have been added. The scope of clinical anthropometric and biochemical testing, CAB, or biomarker component has been expanded to include measurement of blood pressure and blood glucose levels. NFHS4 sample has been designed to provide district and higher level estimates of various indicators covered in the survey. Estimates of indicators of sexual behavior, husband's background and woman's work, HIV/AIDS knowledge, attitudes and behavior, and domestic violence will be available at state and national level only. As in the earlier rounds, International Institute for Population Sciences, Mumbai acted as the nodal agency to conduct NFHS4. The main objective of each successive round of the NFHS has been to provide essential data on health and family welfare and emerging issues in this area. NFHS score data will be useful in setting benchmarks and examining the progress in health sector the country has made over time. Besides providing evidence for the effectiveness of the ongoing programs, the data from NFHS score help in identifying the need for new programs with area-specific focus. Information on the women's characteristics, marriage, fertility, children's immunizations and health, sexual behavior, HIV/AIDS, domestic violence, child care, nutrition, contraception, etc. was canvassed in the women's schedule. The men's schedule covered the men's characteristics, marriage, his number of children, contraception, fertility preferences, nutrition, sexual behavior, attitudes towards gender roles, HIV/AIDS, etc. The biomaker schedule covered measurements of height, weight, and hemoglobin levels for children, measurements of height, weight, hemoglobin levels, blood pressure, and random blood glucose level for women aged 15 to 49 years and men aged 15 to 54 years. In addition, women and men were requested to provide a few drops of blood from a finger prick for laboratory testing for HIV. Coming to the findings of NFHS surveys, First National Family Health Survey, NFHS-1. In this, 18 population research centers located in universities and institutes of national repute assisted IIPS in all stages of conducting NFHS-1. All the state level and national level reports for the survey have already been published, 48 reports in all. NFHS estimated crude birth rate of 28.7 per 1000 population for the period of 1990 to 1992. The total fertility rate is 3.4 children per woman. Contraceptive knowledge is universal. There are wide variations in fertility levels among the states. Fertility is considerably below the national average in South India, that is Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu, and West India, that is in Goa, Gujarat and Maharashtra. Two states, Kerala and Goa, have reached below replacement fertility. Women aged 45 to 49 at the time of survey had born an average of 5.1 children per woman. The maternal mortality rate is estimated to be 437 maternal deaths per 1 lakh live births. Second, National Family Health Survey, NFHS-2. 37% of ever married women aged 15 to 49 are currently employed, up from 32% in NFHS-1. The crude birth rate is 25 per 1000 population, down from 29 per 1000 population as per NFHS-1. The total fertility rate is 2.9 births per woman, down by half a child from 3.4 births per woman in NFHS-1. The median age at first birth for women aged 20 to 49 is 19.6, unchanged from NFHS-1. Knowledge of sterilization was already high at the time of NFHS-1, but the knowledge of other methods has increased by about 10 to 13 percent points since then. Almost half of currently married women aged 15 to 49 use a contraceptive method. 34% of women are sterilized and 2% reported that their husbands are sterilized. In NFHS-3, 68% of households have electricity, up from 60% in NFHS-2. 88% of households use an improved source of drinking water. Only 29% of households have improved toilet facilities. NFHS-3 provides information on key population, health, and nutrition indicators for socially and economically vulnerable groups to examine health inequalities. Caste, tribe status, wealth status, slum and non-slum population in 8 cities. What is the wealth index? Uses of information on 33 household assets and housing characteristics such as ownership of consumer items, type of dwelling, source of water, and availability of electricity, combines this information into a single wealth index using a scientific method of assigning weight to individual components. The household population is divided into 5 equal groups of 20% each quintiles at the national level, from 1 lowest, that is poorest, to 5 highest and wealthiest. There is a steady decline in the proportion of women aged 20 to 24 marrying before the legal minimum age of marriage as per NFHS 3. There have been improvements in antenatal care, institutional deliveries and assistance at delivery by a health professional, but the changes over time have been slow. Immunization coverage for children has improved for all vaccines except DPT. Full immunization coverage has not changed much in the last 7 years. Undernutrition and anemia among children remain major challenges. Adults suffer a dual burden of undernutrition and overnutrition. 63% women and 81% men think that information about HIV/AIDS should be taught in schools to both boys and girls. More than 40% of women and 60% of men are in favor of teaching both boys and girls about sexual behavior and condom use to avoid sexually transmitted diseases. Adults are less likely to favor teaching about contraception than about HIV/AIDS. HIV prevalence among NFHS3 household population of men and women aged 15 to 49 is 0.28%. Based on these estimates and other data, the Government of India has reduced its official HIV estimate for the adult population. However, strong programs are still required to prevent the further spread of HIV. Coming to 4th National Family Health Survey, it was done for 2015 and 16. The survey was conducted after collecting information from 6 lakh households, 7 lakh women, 1.3 lakh men. For the first time, it provides district level estimates. The figures of NFHS 4 and that of earlier rounds may not be strictly comparable due to differences in sample size, and NFHS 4 will be a benchmark for future surveys. NFHS 4 fieldwork for India was conducted from 20 January 2015 to 4th December 2016 by 14 field agencies and gathered information from 601,599 households, 699,686 women and 103,525 men. Fact sheet for each state, union territory and district of India are also available separately. Coming to the other findings, infant mortality rate has declined from 57 to 41 per 1000 live births between NFHS 3 and NFHS 4. IMR has declined substantially in almost all the states during the last decade. IMR reflects that concerted efforts and focused interventions in this sector can translate to improved outcomes. Sex ratio at birth, number of females per 1000 males, has improved from 914 to 919 at national level over the last decade. It is highest in Kerala, 1047, followed by Meghalaya, 1009, and Chhattisgarh, 977. Haryana also witnessed a significant increase from 762 to 836. Institutional births has increased by 40 percentage points from 38.7% in NFHS 3 to 78.9% in NFHS 4. Total fertility rate, TFR, also has declined to 2.2 children per woman from 2.7 in NFHS 3. Thus, it is moving closer to target level of 2.1. There was a decline by 7 percentage points, a consequence of improved child feeding practices and focus on nutritional aspects of children. This is reflected in underweight children. There was substantial decline of anemia from 69% in NFHS 3 to 58% in NFHS 4 among children aged 6 to 59 months. Overall, women in the first phase states, union territories, are having fewer children. The total fertility rates or the average number of children per woman range from 1.2 in Sikkim to 3.4 in Bihar. All first phase states, union territories except Bihar, Madhya Pradesh and Meghalaya have either achieved or maintained replacement level of fertility, a major achievement in the past decade. More than half of the children in 10 out of 15 states are still anemic, shows National Family Health Survey NFHS 4 for 15-16. It also showed that more than half of women were anemic in 11 states. Findings for the 13 states of Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Goa, Haryana, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Meghalaya, Sikkim, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, Tripura, Uttarakhand, West Bengal and two union territories of Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Puducherry show promising improvements in maternal and child health nutrition. Better care for women during pregnancy and childbirth contributes to reduction of maternal deaths and improved child survival. Almost all mothers have received antenatal care for their most recent pregnancy, and increasing number of women are receiving the recommended 4 or more visits by the service providers. More and more women now give birth in healthcare facilities, and rates have more than doubled in some states in the last decade. More than 9 in 10 recent births took place in healthcare facilities in Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Andhra Pradesh, Goa, Karnataka, Puducherry, Sikkim, Tamil Nadu and Telangana, providing safer environments for mothers and newborns. The results from NFHS 4 in 15 states and union territories indicate that fewer children are dying in infancy and early childhood. After the last round of NFHS survey in 2005 and 2006, infant mortality has declined in all first phase states, union territories for which trend data are available. All 15 states, union territories have rates below 51 deaths per 1000 live births, although there is considerable variation among states and union territories. Infant mortality rates range from a low of 10 in Andaman and Nicobar Island to a high of 51 deaths per 1000 live births in Madhya Pradesh. Full immunization coverage among children aged 12 to 23 months varies widely in the first phase states, union territories. At least 6 out of 10 children have received full immunization in 12 of the 15 states or union territories. In Goa, West Bengal, Sikkim and Puducherry, more than 4/5 of the children have been fully immunized. Since the last round of a national health survey, the coverage of full immunization among children has increased substantially in the states of Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Goa, Sikkim, West Bengal and Meghalaya. Married women are less likely to be using modern family planning in 8 of the first phase states and union territories. There has been an increase in the use of modern family planning methods only in states of Meghalaya, Haryana and West Bengal. The decline is highest in Goa, followed by Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Despite the decline, about half or more married women are using modern family planning in 8 of 15 states and union territories. Poor nutrition is less common than reported in the last round of NFHS survey. Fewer children under 5 years of age are now found to be stunted, showing intake of improved nutrition. In 9 states and union territories, less than 1/3 of children are found too short for their age. While this reveals a distinct improvement since the previous survey, it is found that in Bihar and Madhya Pradesh and Meghalaya, more than 40% of children are stunted. Wasting is still very high by international standards in all of the states and union territories. Anemia has also declined but still remains widespread. More than half of children are anemic in 10 out of 15 states or union territories. Similarly, more than half of women are anemic in 11 states or union territories. Overnutrition continues to be a health issue for adults. At least 3 in 10 women are overweight or obese in Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Andhra Pradesh, Goa, Puducherry and Tamil Nadu. Indian families in the first phase households are now more inclined to use improved water and sanitation facilities. Over 2/3 of households in every state or union territory have access to improved source of drinking water, and more than 90% of households have access to an improved source of drinking water in 9 out of 15 states. More than 50% of households have access to improved sanitation facilities in all first phase states and union territories except Bihar and Madhya Pradesh. Use of clean cooking fuel, which reduces the risk of respiratory illness and pollution, varies widely among the first phase states and union territories, ranging from only about 18% of households in Bihar to more than 70% of households in Tamil Nadu and more than 80% of households in Puducherry and Goa. Coming to the conclusion, the objective of NFHS is to provide national and state estimates of fertility, practice of family planning, infant and child mortality, maternal and child health, and utilization of health services provided to mothers and children. The main objective of each successive round of the NFHS has been to provide essential data on health and family welfare and emerging issues in this area. NFHS 4 data will be useful in setting benchmarks and examining the progress in health sector in the country has made over time. Besides providing evidence for the effectiveness of the ongoing programs, the data from NFHS 4 help in identifying need for new programs with area-specific focus. For the first time, NFHS provides district-level estimates in NFHS 4. This indicates that in every round, there is an improvement in the quality as well as in the depth of information. Thank you.